Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the structural formula, the bond line formula and the IUPAC name of the isomers of C6H10. So it is very essential for us to understand what are the different kind of isomers that would be for the molecular formula C6H10, and along with that we are going to do the bond line formula for that also. So let us do that. So now we are going to discuss about the structural bond formula, bond line formula and the IUPAC name of them, and starting with the first one, that is the isomer for C6H10. And let me tell you that this is the molecular formula that has been given as C6H10. So this is the one that has been resembling to the general formula, that is CnH2n-2. The reason being that is, if you consider C6 as the number of n as 6, and if you consider the that is 2n-2, then 2n will be basically 12, and 12-2 basically is 10, and that makes us to understand that this is an isomer for an alkyne, and the alkyne consists of, in this case, consists of basically 6 carbon atoms. So now let us do the structural formula and of the different isomers of the C6H10. So starting with the first one, the first isomer that we are going to represent about in this case is, that is, it would be a straight chain alkyne, so therefore it would consist of 6 carbon atoms in a straight chain, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon atoms would be in a straight chain, and yes, we have to number it in this form, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 carbon atoms are in a straight chain, and we could see that if this is an alkyne, then suppose the first isomer would be where we could see that the carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, the both consist of that is between carbon number and carbon number two, that is carbon-carbon triple bond, and the rest would be basically in hydrocarbon. So therefore, we could write it over here as CH3. Here would be CH2. Here would be again CH2, and here also it would be CH2. But this carbon would not consist of any kind of hydrogen because valences have been fulfilled, and now this consists of a hydrogen atom. So now talking about, this is the structure that we have. So it is very easy for us to represent it in a zigzag form, or we could say it as a bond line formula. So let us understand that also, because it consists of 6 carbon atoms. So therefore we could write it over here in this form, that is, this is the first carbon atom, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. While again also we are going to numbering it, so we will number it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the carbon-carbon triple bond is the one which is at carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore we could write it over here like this one. So this is the, that is the bond line formula of the first isomer of C6H10, and so this has been done, but the main thing is that has been left out is the IUPAC nomenclature of this structure. So it is very much simple to understand that it consists of 6 carbon atoms and having the carbon-carbon triple bond at carbon number 1. So therefore the name of this would be, that is, hex, that is 1-ine. Very simple. Now let us move on with the second type of isomer, second isomer of this molecular formula C6H10, and it would be like the first one only, but there will be the difference in the position of the carbon-carbon triple bond. So therefore here we have found out that the carbon 1 and carbon, between carbon 1 and carbon 2, there was carbon-carbon triple bond, but now we could also right an isomer where we could see that the carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 consist of only one carbon-carbon single bond, while the carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, that is between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, there will be carbon-carbon triple bond. So this is another example that we could represent for the formulas C6H10. So now we are going to represent the second one, that is, the structure would be in this form, that is CH3C triple bond C, and here it would be basically again 3 carbon atoms that would be joined over here, where the last one would consist of CH3, while the inner one would consist of CH2. So talking about the structural formula of this thing, so structural formula of this thing has been done, and bond line formula would be, it consists of 4, it consists of basically 6 carbon atoms, so therefore we could write it in this way. This one would be the first carbon atom that I have written over here, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. But the numbering is also very important. So in this case, suppose say for the structure form, if we see that the numbering will start from this case, that is from that end where we could see that the carbon-carbon double bond is the one where we could get a very less number in that case. So therefore, this one is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. So between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, there we could see a carbon-carbon triple bond. So even we have to number it from that sequence, but sequencing the number is very much important so as to understand that where actually the carbon-carbon triple bond is, or where is the, actually the functional group. So therefore, this one would be the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. And between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, we could find carbon-carbon triple bond. So therefore, this is carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So here it is what we found, carbon-carbon triple bond. So this is the bond line formula that we could represent. And talking about the IPC nomenclature, the previous one was hex 1 ion, but this would be hex 2 ion. Very simple. And talking about the next one, so the next one will have the carbon-carbon triple bond between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, while the carbon number 2 and carbon number, between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, there will be only one bond present between carbon and carbon. So now let us draw the another isomer of this thing, where this consists of the structure like this one that I am representing. And it consists of basically 6 carbon atoms that are being present in a straight chain. And let us number that. So this one would be the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. And between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, there would be a triple bond. So this is what the triple bond is. And let us fulfill the hydrogen atoms over here. So therefore, this would be CH3. Even here, it would be CH3. This one would be CH2. This one again would be CH2. And there is no hydrogen being required in this case because the carbon has been fulfilled with its valency or with its bond, because it forms 4 bonds. And now let us do the bond line formula for this one. So the bond line formula would be very much easy. That is again 6 carbon atoms that would be in a straight chain. So therefore, this is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. So between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, there is carbon-carbon triple bond. So it is very essential for us to name to number it also. So therefore, this would be the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth carbon atom. And between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, we could find a triple bond. So therefore, here it, where we have represented carbon-carbon triple bond between carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. So the name of this one would be, yes, we have studied the IUPAC nomenclature of alkynes and the rules of that also. So therefore, the name of this would be hex 3 ion. So this is the third isomer that we have represented. So will the fourth isomer will be in a such a manner that the carbon-carbon triple bond will be between carbon number 4 and carbon number 5? No, that won't be. Because if carbon-carbon double bond, triple bond is present between carbon number 4 and carbon number 5, then the same structure is resembling to the second isomer that we have drawn. And the numbering will not start from here. The numbering will start from here, making to be called as that is hex 2 ion. So therefore, the next isomer, it won't be a straight chain, it would be a basically a branched one. So this is the straight chain isomer that we have drawn in this way, and there will be a branched chain that would be the next isomer. So let us focus on that. So the fourth one would be, so the fourth one would be in such a manner that the 5 carbon atoms that have been in a straight chain, and one would be a basically a branching one. So let us concentrate on that. So suppose this is the 5 carbon atoms that I have mentioned over here, and there would be a branching. There would be a branching in such a manner that at least the main thing is this carbon-carbon atoms or this chain that I have made, even this should consist of basically carbon-carbon triple bond, because this is the only thing that we could observe that this is the longest chain, and this long chain consists of 5 carbon atoms. It means at least here carbon-carbon triple bond should be present. So I am mentioning it as carbon number 1. So I am also representing as carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So now the branching can't start over from here. So suppose if I mentioned over here as a branching as a carbon, this one would be the again, that is the second isomer that we have represented. Here I can't introduce a branch one because the carbon series has been fulfilled with its valency. But yes, here I could introduce a carbon atom or a methyl group. So therefore, we could write it over here as CH3. Now let's fulfill the hydrogen atoms. So therefore, this one would be the CH3, this one would be CH2, here it would be CH. no need of any hydrogen to replace over here, and here would be only 1H. So therefore this is the structure that we have. And talking about we have also numbered it. And talking about the bond line formula, the bond line formula would be very much easy to represent. So therefore it consists of 5 carbon atoms that have been present in a straight chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms are in a straight chain, and let me number that also. This is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So between in this case we see the carbon-carbon triple bond is at carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore we could write it over here, that is between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, there will be presence of, that is, triple bond. So this is what we have represented. And on carbon number 3 we could find a methyl group. So therefore methyl group can be represented as this one. So this is the bond line formula of the fourth isomer that we have represented. But what is the name of this one? It is very much easier to understand, because as we have numbered it from that end where we could get a carbon-carbon triple bond nearer to that end. So therefore, in this case, the third position consists of methyl groups. So therefore, the methyl group should be mentioned it first, and then we'll move on to the parent alkane or parent alkyne in this case. So therefore, we have got 3 methyl. That is the third position of the carbon atom where methyl is been present. So 3 methyl, and the total number of carbon that is been present in a straight chain is nothing but 5 carbon atoms, making this to be called as pentane in terms of an alkane. But this is not pentane, this is pentane. And moreover, the carbon-carbon triple bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, making this to be called as 3 methyl pent-1-ine. Simple. Now let us move on with the next one, that is the next isomer that we are going to represent about. So the next isomer would be very much similar to this one. The only difference is this methyl group is on the carbon or 3, or the position of the methyl group is at carbon number 3. Now there it would be at carbon number 4. So that's a kind of minor difference that we could see. So therefore we will take a reference of this one again. So therefore it consists of basically 5 carbon atoms, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms that have been present in the straight chain, and the carbon-carbon triple bond is between carbon number 1 and 2, and the methyl group is present at carbon number 4. So this is the methyl group, that is CH3. So now we have to fulfill the hydrogen atoms. So therefore here it would be CH3, here would be CH, while here it would be CH2. No need of hydrogen to be to mention over here, and only one hydrogen atom would be represented. So this is the isomer, or the fifth isomer that we have represented, but yes, we have to represent the bond line formula of that also. So that could be represented in this way, that is, it consists of 5 carbon atoms that have been present in a straight chain. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms have been present in a straight chain, and between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 where we could see carbon-carbon triple bond. And this is how we have represented carbon-carbon triple bond. And at carbon number 4, or at the position number 4, we could find a methyl group. So this is the methyl group that we have represented. So we have did that, and the only thing is we have not mentioned the IUPAC nomenclature. So therefore the IUPAC nomenclature in this case would be, as on the fourth position we see methyl group is present, so therefore the name is we see 4-methyl. The total number of carbon in a straight chain in this case is 5, making this to be called as pentane in terms of an alkane. But this is alkyne, and the position of the carbon-carbon triple bond is between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, making this to be called as pent-1-ine. So again, this is an isomer that we have mentioned, but yes, there are more isomers also that we have to mention. So the next one is, here we could see that the CH3 was at 4th position. But can we move this CH3 to 5th position? If we move this CH3 to or attached to the 5th carbon atom, then this structure would be resembled to the first structure that we have did, that is hex-1-ine. So that won't be considered to be an isomer. So therefore in this case what we could do is we could shift the carbon-carbon triple bond, that is, it is between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. Now we could arrange it in such a manner that we could see between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So again we can get an isomer. So let us check about that. So this is the sixth isomer that I'm going to represent, and it consists of basically 5 carbon atoms in a straight chain, and one is would be the branching one. So therefore this is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth carbon atom been present, and the double bond will start from carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. But first of all let us number it. So this one would be the first carbon atom, second carbon atom, third, fourth, and fifth. So the carbon carbon triple bond is been present between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So I have represented over here in this way, and the branching would be again same on the fourth carbon atom like CH3. So in this case, the thing that we have to do is we have to fulfill the hydrogen atom. So we will fulfill it over here as CH3, even here as CH3, while no need of hydrogen over here, no need of hydrogen over here, and one hydrogen would be over here so as to fulfill the valency. And now let us draw the bond line formula. So it is very easy to draw for that, because it consists of 5 carbon atoms that have been linearly arranged. So therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon atoms have been arranged, so we have to number it. So this is first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. And the carbon-carbon double bond, actually it starts between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. So it has been present in that position, so therefore I would write it over here in this way. And the next thing that we have to do is, yes, we have to represent the position of CH3 also. The position of CH3 is carbon number 4, so therefore it would be represented in this way. So what would be the name of this thing? The name is very much simple to understand, because it would consist of that is a carbon-carbon triple bond between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, so making this to be called as hex 2-ion, but the position of CH3 is at fourth carbon atom, so making this to be called as 4-methyl, that is pent. Again, it would be pent. The position of the triple bond is pent 2-ion. So this is the isomer that we have got, and was very much simple to understand. But and now moving on to the last isomer. Even the last isomer can be possible, and what is that? Let me show you. So the seventh one will consist of basically four continuous carbon atom, and which would consist of the branching also. So this would be in this form, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and the carbon-carbon triple bond should be there at least, so as to make that it would be an alkyne. So therefore here it would be carbon-carbon triple bond, and here it would be the branching one. So we could mention it this way also. And from where the numbering will start? From the branching? No, because this is not alkane, this is alkyne. So therefore this one would be the number 1, 2nd, 3rd and 4th carbon atom. And let us fulfill the hydrogen atoms over here. So therefore this would be CH3. Here also it would be CH3. Here also it would be CH3. And no need of hydrogen over here. And one hydrogen atom would be over here. So now the thing is, we have to make the bond line formula for that. So in this case, as we could see, that 4 carbon atoms have been present in a straight chain or continuous form. So therefore, the 4 carbon atoms can be represented as carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. So let us number this also. So we'll number it as carbon number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And in this case, carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, we could see carbon-carbon triple bond. So therefore, this is the bond that we observe. And on position number 3, and again on position number 3, we could find a methyl group. So therefore, we could write it as, here it has methyl group, and here also it has a methyl group. So now what would be the name of this one? Very simple, because we have to mention the methyl groups or the substituent groups to be first, and then we'll move on to the parent alkyne. So in this case, basically there are two methyl groups that are being attached and on the position number 3, so therefore it could be called as 3,3-dimethyl. And the total number of carbon in a straight chain is basically 4, called to be as butane in terms of an alkane. And but it is not an alkane, it is an alkyne, where we could see that the carbon-carbon triple bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So therefore the name of this will be but-1-ion. So this were the isomers and the bond line formula for the molecular formula C6H10. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you share this video with your friends. And just don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.